everyone, James Wise here, and today we are back with another reaction video. I'm actually sporting my Poppy Loves You t-shirt. So, if you guys know Poppy, you guys are instantly awesome. If you guys don't know who Poppy is, well, you're missing out, and you should probably YouTube search Poppy. Because it's awesome. Well, today we are here with another reaction video. And this time we're going to be reacting to, hopefully I'm pronouncing this correctly, Ryan Hayashi on Penn & Teller Fool Us. A lot of people actually sent me this. I'm actually very, very behind on the Penn & Teller Fool Us TV show. I've only watched the first episode of the newest season, and then I just haven't caught up with it because I've just been busy with other stuff. So, haven't seen this yet, but a lot of my friends and family have been sending this to me on like Facebook and Instagram or Twitter. I don't know why I said Instagram. So it must be good. So I am definitely looking forward to it. Hopefully it's good. So if you are new here, hit that subscribe button. And of course, if you like this video, hit that like button. Follow me on my social media platforms. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. So without further ado, let's get started.
Ryan Hayashi.
Okay, I said it right.
As a kid, I had two heroes, Bruce Lee and David Copperfield. They inspired me. I wanted to do what they did. The martial arts and magic are very similar because they both come from older traditions that have been passed down over centuries. You have to master certain movements to the point
Wasn't this guy on Britain's Got Talent?
Having flow and making it your own.
I could be wrong, but I think this guy was on Britain's Got Talent.
The magic in the martial arts was the samurai madman of magic. I cut up vegetables around people's heads, blindfolded, without killing them.
Fruit ninja, right?
I'm shedding my samurai character and stripping down my performance to magic in its purest form, showing off what I can do with a few coins that fit in my pocket.
All right.
Please welcome the coin magic of Ryan Hayashi.
That's Japanese for time to get my freak on. How you guys doing?
Feel like that translation is slightly off.
When I was a kid in the 1980s, I saw Penn and Teller on television performing an act with just a pencil and a cigarette. This act fooled me and taught me the basics of magic. So Penn, Teller, I now present to you what you inspired in me 30 years ago. I'm going to hurt your brain using these four cards and four coins in an original routine I call the Ultimate Matrix.
In just a moment, these
coins are going to magically appear and disappear, changing their positions around the square, traveling from their corners to all come together, gathering here in this corner and landing underneath this square. And if I can create the illusion that those coins move without me using my hands, well then, I might just fool you.
I'm pretty sure I remember hearing Penn say that he's not a big fan of Matrix tricks.
Four coins in a square. A card over each coin. Watch closely because this does happen very fast. Hi-shaw! And I just did it. Was that too fast for you? Not a problem. Everybody, do not blink your eyes. And I'll just do it one more time.
This guy's really clean. I'll definitely give him that. Teller, just like, oh god.
So you can actually see the coins traveling one at a time. I'll start here openly so you can see everything.
Any magician that knows the Matrix tricks definitely is
travel.
Probably getting fooled by this.
Watch the next one. Go from the side.
Oh damn.
Now the people from this side may actually see the last one disappear from my fingertips. Watch this last coin vanish, creating a tremor in the force as 100,000 children watching this suddenly decide that magic is cool.
This guy's, I'm totally getting this guy's persona. This guy's, his personality is awesome.
May Google me now.
All right.
This time visibly, so you actually see each coin jump. This is the part that hits people hard. All I have to do is make the mysterious Asian sounds.
You always gotta do the Asian sounds.
I'll do it again. And that makes three.
Hoi!
The next one, no hands, just because I can.
Because I can.
Vanishes here, reappears in the corner, and I'm in beast mode.
I'm in beast mode. Cool. All right, I'm kind of digging this guy. This guy's awesome.
Cards for cover. This time, no cards, just my bare hands and a dose of honesty. I've been performing magic since I was 8 years old, and it took me 12 years to create this act. So for me, this is not just a magic trick. This is something far deeper and 1,000 times more savage. A work of terrifying beauty that has been growing all my life like an uncontrollable weed in the garden of my mind.
Okay.
I have crossed oceans of time and vast empires to be here today, so I take the honor of performing here very seriously. The amount of mental energy I've invested in creating this act could demolish planets. This is the most epic monologue in the history of the world, for I am here to inflict psychological damage, and that means we're not done yet.
All right. That's pretty impressive. Plus, that monologue was extremely impressive, too.
You've now seen the devastation I can generate using two hands. Let's take this to the next level. I'll do it again with just one hand. You could ask any magician around the world about performing an illusion this clean using just one hand, and they will tell you that it is physically impossible. And it looks like this. Booyah.
Booyah!
Watch the next one. I get nowhere near those coins with my hand, and still vanishes from here.
Damn.
Reappears in the corner, and I am the Jackie Chan of magic.
The Jackie Chan magic. Yes, you are, sir.
The next one will invisibly fly from here to there, forming a perfect square. It happens on the count of three. Get ready for this. I've seen it all. Nosebleeds, seizures. There's one. There's two. That's three.
Ooh.
And as promised, I can now actually show you a perfect square formed by one, two, three, and four coins with just.
Damn. That was good.
You would not believe how epic this feels. My heart is pumping. I can feel the adrenaline pulsing through my veins.
Bro,
with me, because just being here,
does this guy drink like a six pack of Monster before getting on stage?
If you have a dream, never give up believing in your dream, living your dream, and doing something every day to make that dream happen. But remember one thing: no matter who you are, no matter how hard you work,
oh wow, nice,
who you think you are and what you do, there will always be an Asian who takes it to the next level.
There will always be an agent that can take to the next level. Okay. I saw people post that in comments. I didn't know what they were talking about. That's where they got it from. Okay. There will always be an agent that takes it to the next level.
This is really incredible. I didn't know if I wanted to look at you or just watch Teller be so amazing.
Yeah, all right.
Oh my gosh, you really are the samurai of magic, of coin magic.
Feel the heat radiating off of me right now. I am a walking cloud of testosterone right now. I feel like zombie Bruce Lee on steroids.
A zombie Bruce Lee.
I don't even know how to talk to you. I'm so impressed.
Wind me up and let me go.
Okay.
I'm like a ninja Shakespeare crossed with Hannibal Lecter.
Okay.
You have to ask me a question, Elsa.
No, I just want to watch you.
Please ask me a question.
Okay. What do you eat for breakfast? Because I need to start eating.
I live on broccoli and blueberries. Can I say something really honest to Penn and Teller? When I was a kid, really, they blew me away with this act they do with a pencil. And being able to come here today, I've never met them before today, and show this to them. It's not me showing my work. It's showing them the effect one act on TV can have on a little kid, you know? It's like bringing it back to them and saying, welcome home.
Yeah.
That's means amazing. A lot to me.
That's
really,
really cool. That's awesome. Yeah, definitely.
I googled the show. This is season 5 and the last 4 seasons before me. 240 performers on this stage, only 3 coin guys before me. And that means something. It's
really
to put a coin app together, make it
feels like there's more coin guys than that.
My best. I hope it resonated with the people. I hope
you guess he's done his homework.
Oh, Ryan, baby. Boy, that's wow. That's a really good act. And you were just saying how hard coin magic is to do. And we've done versions of Matrix, or Tella has, and we've seen Matrix a zillion times. But you added to that so much comedy and personality, and also a really different, fresh way to do that, a fresh style. The bravado coupled with the comedy on that, the wink on every bit of it. And we were, we were following you. And then we followed you a lot. You know, we know how to do those moves, and we followed you and followed you, and then we just gave up. You just beat us into submission with pure skill. So the last few things you did, we have no idea how you did them because we were just enjoying it too much.
Oh, great.
It fooled us. Yeah.
It fooled us? Oh, dude. Dude, that's amazing. Bro. Bro, congratulations on that, man. Like, you actually fooled them. That's awesome. I mean, when you first got on and you started doing Matrix tricks, I was a little hesitant at first, you know, just being honest, just because, I don't remember where it was, but I remember Penn saying in a past episode that he's not a big fan of Matrix tricks, and, you know, Matrix tricks have been done a billion times, so, when you first went on, I was just expecting a normal kind of Matrix tricks with maybe, like, a little twist here and there. But, no, dude, like, you totally blew it out of the water. Like, one, the kind of the same thing what Penn was saying was that, you know, I was kind of following along. Okay, you know, Matrix tricks, these are the moves. And then eventually you're just like, okay, just, I don't even know anymore, man. dude, that was really good. That was probably the best Matrix routine I've seen. Now, I mean, I've done Matrix routines in the past. I don't do them often, but I've done them in the past, and that was super, super clean. Probably one of the cleanest Matrix routines I've seen out there. And, wow, that was... No, okay, and not only... I mentioned this in my reactions to the Sacred Rihanna, America's Got Talent performances. It's not just about the tricks. It's about the performance. I mean, the trick itself, that was absolutely amazing. That was probably one of the cleanest Matrix routines I've ever seen. But the performance that he had around everything, he was just he was kind of a cliche Asian persona kind of guy. Just like, you know, arigato, hoo-hoo, you know, I don't know. but I just like that. I like the whole monologues, the whole attitude he had around it was absolutely extremely awesome, extremely enjoyable, and just made it really entertaining. I would probably say the only downside, I mean, from watching this, or by putting this from like a layman's perspective, it was probably a little too repetitive, but that's from a layman's perspective. As a magician, I mean, I loved it, you know, and I'm sure a lot of other magicians loved it. So, I mean, that was absolutely awesome. I loved it. So, just, hey, man, congrats on you, man. Congrats on Fooling Penn and Teller. I mean, you're probably not watching this, but if you are, just congrats, man. That was absolutely awesome. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you liked this video, hit that like button. If you're new here, hit that subscribe button. Hit that little notification button so you'll get notified whenever I upload a new video. And then also, lastly, follow me on social media. Follow me on Twitter, follow me on Instagram, and follow me on Facebook. Links are down below. Until next time, I will see you guys next time.